Nathan.
Hi, I'm Charlie.
Hi, I'm Kathleen.
And together, we're High Five!
Oh, g'day. Nathan the Swaggy here. Got my swag right here so I can travel all around. And if I need a rest, just lay down my swag and unroll it. Yep. Ugh. Gee, the sun is hot out here in the Australian bush. Might take a break right now. Just unroll the swag. Oh, gee, that sun is really hot. Might need some shade. Oh, that tall eucalyptus tree looks pretty good. A lot of these in the Australian bush, they're called gum trees. Just unroll my swag under the tree here. Yep, a nice shady spot to have a rest. But you know what I really like? A billabong. A nice cool watering hole to sit by. But I might make one. There's nothing like a rest down by a billabong. When you're tired and hot and thirsty, it is kangaroo, roll out the swag in the shade of a tree. It's very peaceful here, it's where I want to be. Ah, yep, that's nice. A cool billabong to watch as I rest.
Oh, look. Slap, slap, slap.
A roly-poly wombat has come down to have a drink at the billabong.
Slap, slap, slap. Ah, hi, Swaggy Nathan. I heard you'd be in the bush today.
A talking wombat. I think that might be Kathleen Wombat.
Slap, slap, slap.
Oh, I wonder if Kathleen Wombat would like to come and get a bit of shade from the tree. Kathleen Wombat, would you like to come and share this shady tree with me?
Oh, that'd be great. Oh, it's getting so hot today.
Great. I'll just make some room for you.
There's nothing like a rest down by a billabong. When you're tired and hot and thirsty, you just can't go wrong, roll out the swag in the shade of a tree. It's really peaceful here, it's where I want to be.
Oh, look, there's Tim Kangaroo.
Well, we better make room for him.
Yeah. Hey, Tim Kangaroo, would you like to come over and share the shade of the tree with us?
Oh, well, thanks, Nathan Swaggy, that'd be great.
There's nothing like a rest down by a billabong. When you're tired and hot and thirsty, you just can't go wrong, roll out the swag in the shade of a tree. It's really peaceful here, that's where I want to be.
I'm a sugar glider hiding in a gum tree. Sweet sugar glider hiding in the trees, peeking through the leaves, sweet sugar glider. Ooh, that tree looks nice. I might head over there. Time for this sugar glider to go for a scamper. Sweet sugar glider scampering on the ground, not making any sound, sweet sugar glider. Climbing up, up, up the tree. Oh, high in the treetops now. You know what? I think I like the other tree better. And I know a faster way to get there. Glide through the air. Ready, set, go! Sweet sugar glider, gliding through the air, flying without a care, sweet sugar glider. Whee! It's great fun fun being a sugar glider. Whee! Reporting for duty at the Old Elephants Reserve. An elephant's trunk is like a nose, and it reaches all the way down to its toes. It smells things right across the land, and it picks things up just like a hand. Yep, I'm working at the Old Elephants Reserve with my old elephant friends today. This is Sammy. She's 86 years old. How are you, Sammy?
I'm very well, thanks, Ranger Kathleen, although I'm feeling a bit cold.
Oh, dear. Well, OK, Sammy, here you go. Here's your favourite old blanket.
Oh, thank you, Ranger Kathleen.
And this here is Jimba Elephant. Hey there, Jimba. Do you need some help reading that book?
Yes, please, Ranger Kathleen. It's hard for my 102-year-old eyes to see all the words.
Oh, 102? Wow, what a great age. Oh, don't worry, Jimba. I've got something that might help you read. Here we go. An enormous pair of elephant glasses.
Wow. Thank you. These glasses make everything look so big and clear.
Well, looks like my old elephant friends are happy. An elephant's trunk is like a nose.
Like a nose.
And it reaches all the way down to its toes.
To its toes.
It smells things right across the land.
Across the land.
And it picks things up just like a hand.
Oh, Ranger Kathleen. I seem to have lost my blanket.
Oh, dear, your blanket? Oh, no. Well, I can't see it anywhere. Well, that's strange. And hey, there it is. It's right next to Jimba.
Nice warm blanket.
Look, I've got an idea. Well, it's such a big blanket. Why don't you guys just share it?
I don't mind sharing.
Well, great. Well, you two will be nice and cozy.
Ranger Kathleen, uh-huh. I seem to have lost my glasses.
Your glasses? Oh, dear.
Chip.
Oh, I don't have another spare pair of glasses. Aha! But I do have a magnifying glass that might do.
Yes, it makes everything looks so enormous. This will do fine.
Fantastic. Oh, Sammy, you're shivering.
Yes, I'm feeling rather cold again.
Me too.
Well, no wonder. The blanket's missing again. Oh, I don't have a spare blanket either, but... Aha! I do have a ball. And you know what? I've got an idea of how you guys can keep warm. How about a game of elephant soccer?
Great idea.
Okay, here we go.
Kick it to me, Jimba.
Well, a job well done here. Might go check on the baby elephants now. See ya.
All right, Jimba, play elephant soccer. Come on, kick it to me. Kick it to me.
Kick. I'm trying to play elephant soccer. Big, slow, heavy elephant movements. Dribble, dribble, run and kick. Dribble, dribble, run and kick. I play it in the sun, I play it in the rain. Soccer is my game. Soccer is my game. Ooh,
elephants are strong and powerful. They can kick really hard. Whew. But they're not very fast at getting around. And sometimes these big elephant ears get in the way, slowing me down. I want to be fast and zippy now. And I know one way to do that. Be me. Now for a game of Charlie Soccer. Dribble, dribble, run and kick. Dribble, dribble, run and kick. I play it in the sun, I play it in the rain. Soccer is my game. Soccer is my game. Woo! Yeah!
Hi, I've been watching this centipede. You know, I think it'd be really cool to move like a centipede. But, well, centipedes have lots and lots of legs, and I've only got two legs, so I need some more feet. Hey, guys!
Yeah!
Hi!
What's up, Tim?
Well, do you want to help me do some cool centipede moves?
Yeah, cool, for sure.
All right. Okay. Well, everybody stand in a line. Maybe a beat would help us keep in time.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. One step in front of the other, that's the way from A to B. Keep in step and keep in time, walking together, you and me. Yeah! That was great centipede walking, guys. I think it might be time to get this centipede moving.
Cool, okay, we'll follow you.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Starting on the left and step, step, step.
Wow!
We're a clever centipede.
Yeah, this is fun.
Cool.
I've got an idea. Why don't we try galloping?
Ooh, but do centipedes gallop?
Well, I've never seen one. But I bet this centipede could gallop.
Yeah.
All right, okay, everyone, follow my galloping rhythm.
One foot in front of the other, that's the way from A to B. Keep in step and keep in time, gallop together, you and me.
Oh, yeah, great galloping, guys.
We're a really cool centipede.
Hey, can we try jumping?
Oh, jumping centipede, all right.
Yeah, let's jump.
All right, jump. okay, hold on. Okay, I think we need to start jumping together, so follow my jumping rhythm. Here we go, ready?
Okay.
Jump in front of the other, that's the way from A to B. Keep in step and keep in time, jumping together, you and me.
Woo! Wow, that was really great jumping.
Cool. All right, do you guys want to try all those moves together?
Yeah.
Sure.
All right, let's start with walking. Here we go. And step, step.
Yeah, great walking.
Okay, now let's try galloping. Ready?
Galloper, 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 galloper.
And now jumping, here we go.
Jump, 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 jump.
Fantastic jumping.
Hey, I've got another great centipede move. What about conga?
We know that one.
All right, here we go, ready?
Conga, 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 conga,
conga. We are a caterpillar.
Slithering and sliding snake. Slithering and sliding along the ground, bending and twisting, snake can be found. This snake wants to find a nice sunny place to bask in the sun. Slithering and sliding along the ground, darting and dancing, snake can be found. The snake wants to find somewhere to hide away now. Oh, there's a rock over there. Slithering and sliding along the ground, hiding under rocks, snake can be found. Snake's having a rest. Snake, are you asleep? Sorry, snake. Sweet dreams.
Are you ready for some stargazing chats?
Sure thing, Kel. But it's a bit dark out
here.
Yeah, but look at all those beautiful stars. This carrot juice is really yummy.
Oh, Cal! I see a bunch of stars up there that looks like a butterfly.
Oh, yeah, Chads, I see it. A butterfly with beautiful starry wings. What a great constellation.
Huh? What?
Constellation. It's a word for a group of stars sort of make up a shape.
Well, in that case, I see another constellation, Kel. That bunch of stars up there looks like a bunny shape. It's a star bunny.
A star bunny? Oh, yeah, I see it, Chats. I see it. Oh, looks like a rabbit with big ears.
Kel, I think the star bunny just winked its eye at me.
Really? It winked at you? Wow, that's pretty cool. Must be a very friendly star bunny.
Hey, Kel, I wonder if that star bunny drinks carrot juice like you. Because rabbits love carrots.
Oh, they do, Chats, they do. And you know what else?
What?
Carrots are supposed to be really, really good for your eyes. Some people say that they even help you see in the dark.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Ah, oh, that must be why the star bunny has such twinkly, winky eyes.
Twinkly star in the sky, what do you see? Winking at me, star bunny. Twinkly, blinky, bunny eyes, star bunny. Twinkle and blink and wink and blink at me. Wow, Chats, I'm really glad that I've got my carrot juice here tonight so I can see all these beautiful, amazing star constellations. Hey, what happened to my carrot juice?
Actually, it's funny you should ask, Kel. I saw exactly what happened to your juice.
Oh, yes? And what happened?
It was the star bunny. He jumped down from the sky and drank it all up, every last drop.
Are you sure, Chats? Because I don't really think it was the star bunny. I think you drank all my carrot juice.
Me? Aw, okay, it was me. I drank your juice. I'm really sorry, Kel.
That's okay, Chats. I don't mind.
It's so dark out here under the night sky.
But what's that got to do with carrot juice?
Well, the dark makes me nervous, Kel. And you said carrot juice is good for your eyes, so I thought it might make me see in the dark.
Well, Chats, I didn't realise you were a little bit afraid of the dark.
Shh. Well, I don't tell everyone, Kel. I'm only telling you because I know you understand.
Ah, thanks, Chats. You know what I do when I'm a little bit afraid? What? I think of happy things. Things that make me smile.
Like what?
Ooh, like rainbows, or dancing, or beautiful twinkling stars.
Oh, I know. I can think about the friendly star bunny when I get scared. The star bunny makes me smile.
That's a great idea, Chats. The star bunny can be your very own special twinkling, blinking nighttime friend.
Yeah. Hi, star bunny.
Hi, star bunny.
Something, something carroty. My rabbit nose tells me there's a carrot around here. Aha! A carrot top. Ooh, ooh. That's no good. I'm gonna have to pull harder. Use my feet. One, two, three, pull. Wow! This is the biggest, juiciest carrot I've ever seen. Time to munch and crunch. Oh, this is too big for me. I might take it home and share it.
Once there was a terrier dog called Tosca.
And one sunny morning, Tosca found a big cardboard box in her yard.
What's this? Oh, it's a big brown box. Oh, what's this doing here?
I could put my favourite squeaky toy in there. Oh, all the other dogs in the neighbourhood have a kennel. Oh, this can be mine.
What a great discovery. What a thing to see. A large and roomy kennel that's waiting here for me.
Just then, Tosca's friend Seamus the sheepdog came by.
Great cardboard box there, Tosca.
Yeah, it's my new kennel.
Want to see that? You know what? It'd make a great rocket ship too.
Oh, this sounds like fun.
Yeah. Hey, and then we can blast all the way to the planet Pluto.
Quick, hop in. Okay. Come on, we'll go for a ride.
Okay.
Get ready for blast off. 3, 2, 1, blast off!
What a great discovery. What a thing to see. A big, fast, zooming rocket ship.
But while the dogs were having fun in their pretend rocket ship, their friend Pia the poodle raced in.
Oh, great rocket ship, guys. Mind if I come for a ride?
Yeah, hop in, Pia, hop in.
Oh, there's not a lot of room back here.
Yeah, maybe you should leave your ball outside.
But it's my favourite, and we might want to play outer space ball.
Oh, OK then, come on, get in, get ready for blast off.
Woof, 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 wait for me.
In bounced Pom Pom the Pomeranian with her favourite old blanket. She wanted to fly up in the rocket ship box too.
Oh, hi there, Pom Pom. I don't think there's a lot of room in here.
Phew.
Oh, gee, your blanket's pretty stinky.
You'll have to leave it outside.
But it's my favourite.
Oh. Okay, come on.
Who's standing on my tail?
Oh, who's got their paw in my bag?
Who's tickling me?
I didn't mean to break your rocket ship, Tosca.
Well, that's okay, guys, because you know what? It was an okay kennel, and it was a pretty good rocket ship. Yeah. But it's all flat now. I think it'd make an even better flying carpet.
Yay!
So all the dogs climbed onto the flying carpet with their special things.
Okay, dogs, we're going to need a really big tailwind for takeoff, so get those tails wagging.
And they went for a flying carpet ride.
What a great discovery, what a thing to see. A magic carpet flying high, just made for you and me.
Wow, Tosca, this cardboard box makes a great flying carpet.
It was so much fun.
Well, let's do some more flying then.
Yay, let's fly over there for another great song.
Secret.